All right, Dale, now let's talk about faba beans, or some people call them fava with a V or with a B. It's the same plant. We typically call them faba beans, maybe because we're from the South, I'm not sure. But this is a plant that I really, really like. It's the only bean, it's the only true bean plant that can handle cold, wet soils. All other bean plants need warmer soils or a little drier in order to germinate. But faba beans can handle the cooler soils. I think they probably have a little more cold tolerance than even a pea does. A little bit. They're certainly not in the hairy veg category, but they're probably a little more cold tolerant than a pea. But they're a true bean. Can grow quite tall. You know, these are probably 3 feet tall. But I know when I'm talking to some of the seed companies, they tell me that when they grow these up in the northern part of North Dakota for seed production, these things will get 6 to 7 feet tall. And in the really good areas, these will yield over 100 bushels an acre, which is incredible because we never see anything nearly like that here. The problem that we have here, and the reason that we would never grow these for seed production down here, they're very sensitive to heat. And when the heat comes on, and we haven't even been that hot yet, but you can see on this plant that some of these flowers have just turned black. And that's a response to heat. That's those flowers just simply aborting and turning black because it's been too hot. We've had a couple, probably 85, 88 degree days. It just burns those flowers right off. So we would never be able to produce good seed production, but it's a great cover crop because you can plant it early in the cool, wet soils. It has a tremendous root system. It's got a big hollow stem, so these things would be super easy to roller tramp down. I mean, you could have 100% termination by rolling over these things because that big hollow stem. And the root system is just fantastic. Now, I pulled up a root, and it brought up that much soil right with it. Dale, I know you pulled one up and kind of shook the dirt off, but look at the, go ahead and describe what you're seeing on that root structure.
I'm seeing nodules everywhere, not just around the main stem like you a lot of times see with the legume. They are all over the branch roots. I mean, of all the legumes that we've looked at so far today, this by far is the most impressive display of nodules. One drawback of the fava beans, where we are out here in cattle country, is that I've never seen cattle really eat it. Apparently it's very bitter, they don't like it. It's the very last thing they eat in the plot every time.
Yeah. And I think part of the reason for that, Dale, is that this particular variety that we've been getting is a high tannin. And so it has that tannin, that bitterness. Now, we're working with some seed companies, and the reason that we're using that variety is because faba beans have large seeds, typically. And so we've been buying the smallest available seed size because that was our number one criteria was seed size, and it happened to be a high tannin type. Mm-hmm. I have a contract written with the company to grow some in North Dakota for us this year that is a low tannin, small seed type. So we'll see when we get those out there in a year or two here, if we have a little better palatability with the animals.
And that would be a great package because if we could get this kind of nitrogen production with all this being edible and palatable to livestock, that'd be a great combination.
Yeah. And the other thing is just look at these branch roots. I mean, it has a nice tap root, but what always has impressed me is just that massive branch roots in that top 2 or 3 inches.
Almost looks like a sunflower root.
It's just a massively rooted, probably from a legume perspective, as deep rooted, massive root system as anything I've seen.
Yeah, a lot of these legumes that we look at, these pulse type legumes, just don't have impressive root systems. This combines the high nitrogen fixation with really a pretty good root system and a lot of above ground biomass as well.
Yeah. So as you can tell, we like faba beans a lot. The thing that's really kept us back from selling a lot of faba beans in the past is that seed size, because they're very large. And if you don't get a small seeded type, they're not going to flow through a drill very well, especially in a mix. But again, some of these companies have been breeding specifically for seed size. And so I think down the road, we'll see better availability of some of these varieties.